Hello, this is Bern, and on today's video, I'm going to share with you how to understand when a guy can't commit. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com. On today's tutorial video, I'm going to be guiding you through 9 overlooked behaviors of men who can't commit so you don't have to waste time entering a relationship that's going to go nowhere. Now, this is a smaller version of a larger masterclass that I've created for you. And if you want to access that as well as this video, on the description of this video, the first link, or somewhere on your screen, there's a click box where you can click on and you can enter name and email and start watching that masterclass as well. And I invite you to do that in addition to watching this. Now, this is not a scoring system like popular magazines like to do nowadays, where they'll say, well, definitely leave the guy or stay with him. Like, no, what I'm gonna give you right now is some nuance. I take it that you're a conscientious, heart-centered, conscious woman who's watching this. So you'll be able to be honest with yourself and know how many of these things, these red flags, is my guy ticking? And if your guy or the guys that you've been attempting to build a relationship with tick a lot of them, then that's a good sign that you need to look elsewhere or do it differently. The first sign of a guy who can't commit may seem simple, but it's not as simple as it seems, because so many women who are smart and beautiful and worthy don't really understand how to do this in practice. Is he is inconsistent in his pursuit of you, or worse, he's not pursuing you at all. Here's what I mean. You know what you have to do for a guy to pursue you? Show up. That's what you have to do. That's basically as simple and as little as it takes. Why? If you show up with an open heart, if you connect with them, then he should have enough to actually actively pursue you. It's different from chasing you, right? You don't want a guy who chases you. You want a guy who is interested in pursuing you. Now, if the guy's not doing that, or he's doing that selectively, right? He's doing it every now and then. He connects with you. He forgets about you. He calls you every couple of weeks, and then he forgets. Then that's a sign that the guy that you're that's pursuing you is not necessarily the best space to take things hands on. Second sign of a guy who's going to have a difficulty committing to you is a guy who hasn't yet figured out his mission in life, what he's here to do, what lights him up, what makes him serve the world at a higher level. Why? Because if he hasn't figured out what he has to do in the world, what makes you think that he can actually distract himself with something that is second nature to him, which is like creating a relationship? If he doesn't know who he is fully, he can only offer you as much as he's offering the world. And if he's not offering the world something great, then that's as much as he'll have to show for you. Now, a caveat to this would be a guy who maybe hasn't figured out his mission, but he's actively pursuing it. He's hungry. He's doing what he can to find his thing. That's a guy worth investing in time and energy. But a guy who is lazy, doesn't know what he wants to do here, and is not really searching for it, will not be able to give you the kind of sustenance that you're seeking. Number 3, he consistently runs away or shuts down in times of stress. What does this mean? This means that all guys will have this at some level. Things get stressful, he wants to go within, but when he predominantly does that, things get stressful and he goes into his cave and you cannot talk to him and you can't get a word out of him and you kind of have to really press for him to share with you what's going on. Or maybe he just disappears. Maybe things get difficult and you don't hear from him for a week. And you're freaking out thinking that maybe something happened to him, and here he is just going through some down times. Every now and then, you understand people go with that, but that's his consistent behavior. His method, instead of taking problems head on and addressing them, is to go away or to shut down. That's a sign that this is going to be commitment, lifelong commitment, is going to be something hard for him to do. Number 4, please pay close attention to this one, and that's he does not follow through with his word. What does that mean? He says, I'm going to be there at 7. He's there at 9. He doesn't even remember that he's at 7. He says, well, we're going to do this in a couple of weeks, and then it doesn't happen. Those are just simple examples. Those are basic examples, but or maybe he commits to something And then midway he quits and he doesn't feel any remorse or any kind of like, I should have completed my thing. When a guy doesn't follow through with his word in small things, can you imagine a lifelong, I'm going to stick to you through thick and thin, through sickness and health? Ain't going to happen. So notice for when guys are able to show up and be men of their word. When he says, I'm going to do something and he does it, that's actively showing you that he has what it takes to take something deeper in commitment and also make it work. If you can't make something simple work, more difficult things, forget about them, right? Number five, he reacts mostly, and I say mostly because we all are defensive at times, but he reacts mostly defensively versus curious when you confront him with something. Let's say he did something that he shouldn't have done, and you come back to him and say, hey, John, let's say, or George, here's what's going on. What happened? That made me feel good. And instead of saying, you know what, I'm sorry about it, or let me think about it, or here's what I meant, he's like, no, the problem is you. Like, he's throwing back defensively the problem as if it belongs to you, instead of taking ownership of the problem and being able to do something about it. Again, that's a big red flag that the guy will be unable to commit. Here's why. Because imagine that a guy is going to say, I'm going to do this for the rest of my life. I'm going to now have to face someone who's attacking me instead of, and it's not true you're not attacking him, you're simply sharing what's going on. But if he has that type of mentality where his word and his vision is the only thing that exists, the only thing that is true, and he can't see his mistakes, that's a really, really bad sign, and you want to move away from that fast, like Forrest Gump. Run, Forrest. Number six, he leaves you out of his future plans and goals. Think about it. If a guy wants something long-term with you, I'm not saying the first week, the first month, the first even couple of months, but the more you're with him, the more he's going to have that sense of, I want to build a future with you, which means he's going to put you into his future plans. He's going to talk about them. He's going to implement them. He's going to co-create them with you. He's going to introduce you to his family. He's going to introduce you to his friends. When he leaves you out of those future plans, and you're like a silo, like a separate entity in his life, it's like two separate lives, his life and your life, then again, that shows you that he doesn't have that long-term vision. When you always have to ask him, what do you want in the future, and he's not bringing it up all of his own, again, not the best sign, not the thing that makes you feel the most comfortable, the most excited to be with someone, where you feel like you have to be his mommy and say, dude, would you like to do something with me in the future? What do you want to do? I mean, a few years from now, do you ever, when he's not stepping up and co-creating this with you, it's not a good sign. Number seven, he fails to stand up to his family in your behalf. He fails to actually, when, let's say, his mom or his dad or his brother is being unkind to you or stepping their toes and being disrespectful. He takes out the popcorn, starts watching the whole interaction as if he's watching some funny film instead of stepping up and saying that this is my woman. Don't do that or stand back or something. If he's unwilling to do that, that's also a sign that the commitment-minded philosophy that he has may not be in alignment with the high standard that you expect for someone who's going to be with you for the rest of his life. Number eight, he has a higher standard for your behavior than his own. He expects you to be a certain weight, let's say, for example. I mean, that should be a disqualification to begin with, but let's say he expects you to look a certain way and he doesn't take care of his appearance, or he expects for you to show up a certain time and he doesn't care about the time he shows up. Or maybe he wants you to be extra kind to friends and family and he's not being even interested in your friends and family. When there's that type of discrepancy on behavior, that's also a sign that the guy is going to have issues with long-term commitment. Why? Because he's going to mostly want to see things from his own vantage point instead of taking into account where you come from, where you stand, and what you really want and crave. Number nine. And this is probably counterintuitive to the ones that I've been sharing with you, but it's so important. A guy can't stand his ground and say no to you when he needs to. So let me repeat that. When a guy doesn't have the backbone, when he doesn't have the guts to say no to you and to say this is unacceptable and push back, when he's just a pleaser, when a guy is just trying to please you but doesn't have a spine, That's a non-committal sign. Here's why. Because as fun as it might seem to you at the beginning that the guy is doing whatever you want, for a guy to commit to a lifelong sentence, and it is a sentence of saying yes to everything you're saying and not have the guts to actually put a stop to things that maybe need to be put a stop to, that means emotional suicide. Imagine that. Imagine if you had to say yes to someone for the rest of your life. Why would you volunteer for that for a long, long time? So again, counterintuitive to the other ones, but a guy who doesn't have enough strength to say no, it's a guy who's going to have a hard time committing to you, because committing to you, having to say yes to everything you want, is going to be a lifelong death sentence. Okay? Hope you find that these are helpful to you. I'm going to ask you for a few little things here if you found this helpful and beneficial. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. And number three, most important of all, first link in the description of this video is going to take you to a masterclass that will allow you to step into this type of relationship that you do want versus the one you don't want. It's free, and all you have to do is enter your name and email once you click on that link, and it's gonna redirect you to that space. Thank you so much for connecting with me. I enjoyed creating this video for you and look forward to connecting with you in the future as well.